Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'd like to take the time to talk a little bit about my past, some about the present, and a little bit about the future. My name is Sid Nowell. I'm the last candidate for the 7th Judicial Circuit. I've been in this community since 1995, and I've been visiting this community since 1978. I graduated from the University of Wisconsin in 1975. That was the law school I graduated from, the undergraduate school in 1971. I'm a product of the New York City public school system, a proud graduate of Brooklyn Technical High School. Upon graduating from law school, I went to Washington, D.C., where I started my career in the solicitor's office of the U.S. Department of Labor. During that first year out of law school, I argued or briefed 11 U.S. Court of Appeals cases. Most lawyers don't get to do that in their entire career. After 1 year, I relocated to Newark, New Jersey, where I became a trial lawyer, and I prosecuted employers and unions, and sometimes employees, who violated our National Labor Relations Act. I then entered a very interesting part of my career. I joined New York City government. I worked for, initially, Ed Koch, then David Dinkins, and Rudy Giuliani. It was 10 years, but that was supposed to only be 3 weeks. In 1995, I moved to Florida. Did not practice law because I was not a member of the bar. I actually taught for 3 years. I taught at the FAA, and I was a substitute teacher in the school district. In 2001, I opened Nowell & Associates, a general practice law firm, and from that point in time to today, I've had approximately 10 lawyers that I've employed at some point in time. It's a general practice firm. It's committed, as I am committed, to the community. I have such clients as I'm the city attorney for the city of Bunnell. I'm the town attorney for Beverly Beach. I'm counsel to the Flagler County School District, Marion County School District, and St. John's County School District. That's my past. The present. Like you, on August 24th, I'm going to have to go into that room and vote for candidates. So I'm going to tell you what I'm going to vote for. First and foremost, I've already addressed experience. I won't reiterate that again. Next, for me, in final importance, is demeanor. Being a judge, being a fact finder, being a determiner of making decisions requires completely different skills from being an advocate. Advocates are there to fight and argue whether they're right or wrong. The judge, as one of my colleagues says, has to do the right thing. For the last 10 years, I've been functioning as an arbitrator and mediator, making and writing decisions, hearing evidence, taking facts, and writing opinions. I've done that for 10 years now. Commitment. When I go in that booth, I want to know the person I'm voting for is committed, committed to the community. I demonstrate that by my commitment to various boards. I'm on the board of directors. I was on the board of directors of the Flagler County Chamber of Commerce for 7 years. I was on the board of directors for the Police Athletic League. I am on the board of directors of the Flagler Hospital Foundation. All these demonstrate a certain commitment I have to my community. And finally, fourth criteria I would be looking for is service. Outside of my practice of law, I am dedicated to the youth of this community. I've spent 15 years in some form or fashion coaching and mentoring kids in this community. For those of you who don't know, I'm the assistant varsity coach and the head JV coach from a Matanzas High School basketball team. But that's not just about basketball. That's about 13 men every year, young men, who want coaching for basketball and mentoring for life. Finally, the future. If elected, what I would like to do is ensure that anybody who passes through my courtroom walks out of there knowing that they've been treated fairly and impartially. When they walk out of that courtroom, they should have an expectation, and they will have an expectation, that I will provide a timely decision. I thank you for taking the time on August 24th. I appreciate your vote. Thank you.